Hello, and welcome back to Real Time. I'm Tyler.
And I'm Molly.
And here we talk about the movies we like.
And the ones we don't.
Today is our first pick from the audience.
Yes, very interesting.
I asked a few people what they would want us to cover, and both of them said the same thing, Fantastic Mr. Fox. This recommendation comes from my Aunt Tish. And a friend of mine, Kennedy Joseph. So, thank you for the recommendation from the both of you. I have seen this movie before, so it was really a first showing for you.
Yes, it was my first time seeing the movie, and I very much enjoyed it.
Yeah, the last time I watched this movie was actually when it came out in 2009. So it's been quite some time since I've seen it. So it was kind of a first showing for me too, but not really.
I read the book in like fourth grade, so you know, I had that knowledge coming in, but this was my first time watching the movie.
So, Fantastic Mr. Fox is directed by Wes Anderson, and it stars George Clooney, Meryl Streep, Jason Schwartzman, Bill Murray, Wallace Wolodarski, Eric Chase Anderson, Michael Gambon, Willem Dafoe, Owen Wilson, Wes Anderson, Helen McCrory, Brian Cox, Adrian Brody, and for some reason, Mario Batali. That's weird. So, this movie is about a quote-unquote fantastic Mr. Fox, who is, at the beginning of the movie, he steals food from farmers to survive, because he is a fox.
Mm-hmm.
That's what they do. But when his wife tells him that she's pregnant, he promises that they aren't going to be stealing anymore, they're going to go legit. And then one day, he decides, I want to steal.
Mm-hmm.
Just one more time.
He buys a new house that overlooks three farms and decides he wants to steal again.
Overlooks three farms from Bogus Bunsen Bean.
Mm-hmm.
The main antagonists of the movie, but mostly Bean. The other two are just his lackeys, more or less. And we just found a flea on our little cat.
Oh, great. I'll get it later.
Get it.
I got it.
Okay.
Sorry.
We saved Willie from the flea.
Yeah. We had one flea epidemic, and now it looks like we're gonna have another.
Dang old fleas, man. Anyways, so after he gets caught stealing by these farmers, they wreck his home under the tree, and so that he and other woodland creatures need to run away from the farmers.
Mm-hmm.
And it's really a cat and mouse game throughout this movie. The farmers going after the animals continually stealing from them, because why not? They gotta do it.
Yeah.
And it's really a quite charming movie.
It really is. I love all the little animals. They're so cute.
You know, this movie was done in stop motion, like Anderson would do later with Isle of Dogs. And I haven't seen that one, but this, I think, is probably some of the best stop-motion animation I've ever seen.
Mm-hmm.
You know, everything is so fluid. There's not really any jankiness to any of the movements. And everything looks really good. Like, they went into a lot of detail to get everything to look just right.
Oh, yeah. It looks amazing. I really love the look of it.
And actually, for Mr. Fox's suit, Wes Anderson went to his own tailor to make that suit for him.
Oh, that's cool.
And this is a very strange movie. It's based on a book by Roald Dahl.
Mm-hmm.
And unfortunately, like a lot of movies based off of Roald Dahl's work, this really didn't do very well at the box office. You know, that's just, I guess, something that Roald Dahl movies really haven't overcome. You know, Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, Matilda, the BFG, none of them really made much money. knows?
Oh, well.
So, yeah. What was your, who's your favorite character in this?
That's a hard question, because there's a lot of characters that I like and that are really cute. I like Ash a lot, the son. I like him. But I also like Christofferson, because he's like a cool fox, but he's also like just kind of timid, and he's soft-spoken, I guess is the word I'm looking for. But yeah, so he's pretty cool. I don't know. It's really hard to choose. What about you?
Yeah, it is really hard to choose, because I like a lot of these guys. Mm. I like Mr. Fox himself.
Yeah, yeah.
He's really fun to watch.
He is, yeah. I also like the little possum.
I was about to say that, too. Yeah. But I also like his wife for actually being able to keep him in check. Like, look, whatever's happening, better not be.
Yeah.
What about favorite scenes? What would you say is your favorite scene?
That's another hard one, because there's a lot going on that I really like. I really don't know.
It's hard, isn't it?
It is really hard. I liked all of it. I guess my favorite part, this is kind of a broad area, but when they first start breaking into each farmer's farm.
Yeah.
Like the first three, I guess. I don't know. It is hard to choose. What about you?
Yeah, I agree. It's really hard to choose.
Yeah.
But there's another character I forgot to mention. I really like the rat played by Willem Dafoe.
Oh, yeah. I do like that rat.
Willem Dafoe is, as usual, very creepy in this movie.
Yep.
that's just the role he plays very well. Just creepy guy.
Mm-hmm.
Whenever he doesn't play someone creepy, it's really, it's kind of weird.
It is,
it's like,
yeah.
This isn't supposed to be happening. What's going on here? So, do we really have a whole... We don't really have a whole lot to say about this movie, actually.
Yeah, I mean, just besides that I liked it. Oh, I also liked the music.
Yeah?
That's another aspect I liked.
I like the music right before they start throwing flaming pine cones. It sounded very Sergio Leone-esque. Sergio Leone-esque.
Yeah.
You know, it sounds like it belonged in a spaghetti western.
Yeah.
At that point it'd be more appropriate to say Ennio Morricone-esque, since he was the one doing the music. But
yeah, I also like the main song, I guess the title song. The doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. I like that one.
So this movie was actually nominated for the best animated feature at the Oscars that year.
Yeah.
It lost to Up, which. That's fine.
I do like Up, but there's something about this one that I think is more artistic and may have deserved to win over Up. I'm not saying I like it more than Up,
but you wouldn't be upset if this had won.
I feel like this one had more creative choices, and it took more risks, I think.
Let me see what else was nominated that year. I'm kind of curious, because as far as I remember, there were some pretty good... You know, that was a pretty stacked year for animation.
Oh.
Let's
see. Who should have won? Or what movie should have won?
Let's see. Okay, so Up, Coraline, Fantastic Mr. Fox, Princess and the Frog, and The Secret of Kells.
I've not seen that one, last one.
Yeah, I haven't seen The Secret of Kells either, but any one of those other four...
They're pretty good.
Yeah, those are great movies. I haven't seen The Secret of Kells. I'm gonna assume it's good. I hope it is, at least.
I'd say out of those, I am leaning towards Fantastic Mr. Fox.
Yeah, that one's a good one. Coraline was also great.
Yeah,
another stop motion animated movie that I really like too. Maybe we should add that to our Halloween list.
Oh, definitely.
So, not only is this our first viewer requested movie, this is also the first in our fall/Halloween list that we're doing. Yeah. You know, we both really like the Halloween season, so we have quite a list of horror movies.
Mm-hmm. And we said this one is fall because the fall colors.
Yeah.
If I had to guess, I'd say the season it's set in is fall. It looks very fall.
Yeah. It's also set in the UK, I'm assuming, so everything already looks dreary.
It has lots of yellows and oranges. So yeah, so that's why we are classifying this as a fall movie.
Now, we're going to be doing a lot of double features for our Halloween movies. So that begs the question, what do we pair Coraline with?
I was going to say Corpse Bride, but it looks like we already have that paired with something.
Yeah, we have that paired with Sweeney Todd.
We could take out Sweeney Todd.
We
will see.
Yeah.
It'll be a surprise.
I'd say Nightmare Before Christmas, but I don't care about that movie.
I know. I never really...
Like, after the first...
After all the good songs.
After the intro, I'm checked out. Yeah. I don't care anymore.
The intro's good,
but, you know, who knows? Maybe we'll do that one for Christmas.
Maybe.
It is a bit more Christmassy than Halloween.
I do classify it more as a Christmas movie, even though all the characters are Halloween. The message it gets across is more Christmassy.
Yeah.
All right, anyways.
That will do it for us today.
Thank you for listening.
See you next time.